pressing to prepare now. He's saying that families need to make sure they have 3 days of food and water in any kind of...
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by.
We're in Grand Isle, Vermont. I'm in an 1810 English cow barn that was converted to an antique shop in the 1940s by Velva McGarity, the last female singer at the male bar at the Hotel New Yorker. And she ran this antique shop. She started it, ran it until she was 92. And I used to buy from her. Actually, I used to come as a little kid. She was a drinker, and so was my mom. So they'd sit out front and have a toddy or two, and as a seven-year-old, I'd run through this dump, not realizing that one day I would be back here, and one day I'd own the place. Is that a great strainer? Yeah. We had some famous people come through here over the years. You know Mike Myers?
Yeah.
He's been here twice. And I got pictures online. I put that picture online.
Yeah.
He came the first time with, I guess, a bodyguard, and then some old geezer was with him. And spent a lot of money. I mean, not a lot of money, but $500.
Yeah.
And he was nice. Really nice guy. And he did the thing he does. You know, that thing he does. At the AA. Nice guy. He has a house near here, but he doesn't want anybody to know him.
Well.
Anyway. The good part of this business is you just never know what's happening or what it's going to be like. One day I'm sitting here and I got a phone call, and it's a guy with a heavy French Canadian accent. He says, my wife, she wants to come and visit your shop. And I said, well, yeah, that's good. Are you open? I said, yes, I'm open. He says, well, we have a problem. And I said, what's that? He says, my wife, she don't wear no clothes. I said, what? He says, she don't wear no clothes. Can she come in your shop? And I thought about it a minute. I was teaching at UVM then, and I thought, boy, I don't know that. Yeah, so I said, yeah, sure, she can come in the shop. I don't care. So they came, and the shop was full of people. She had no clothing on. She's wearing Nike running shoes and no clothes at all. And so I said, hi, how are you? And then when they got ready to leave, he says, would you like a picture taken with my wife? And I thought, geez, I'm at UVM. I don't think that would go over very well. Let's take that picture. But I said, but not inside. Let's take it outside under the sign, Vallee's Den of Antiquity. He said, that's okay with you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The bridge had just opened. You know, just beyond me here, there's drawbridge to the next island. And so we're out there, and he's taking pictures, and the cars are going by, and they're honking because she doesn't have any clothes on. And the sun's out. And And then all of a sudden, this old convertible came. And it was four guys that I have on my Thursday night class at UVM. And one of them hollers out, "Hey, Vallee, you finally got a woman. Wow, look at those tits." And I had to see those guys in class the next night.
Oh,
so you just don't know what's going to happen.